Welcome to Microprocessor Architecture and 8086 Programming. Learning about the capabilities and architecture of microprocessor can significantly improve your programming skills. In this course, we are going to learn first about the theoretical aspects of a microprocessor. For instance, what is a microprocessor? We know that computer takes input, processes it, and then produces output. What exactly is going to happen in this processing part? First, we need to understand what is inside the microprocessor. For example, registers and cache, how the interaction with the memory is going to happen, these things. And then we will learn about instructions. What is an instruction? How it is specified? What are the different integral components inside an instruction? What is opcode? What is operand? How many different ways we can specify operands, how we can get the operands from the memory, how the processor is going to keep track of different operations, all these things. Then the second part is about the abilities of assembly level programming language. What is assembly level programming language? How you can write lower level programs using assembly level language. So these assembly level language capabilities will give you in-depth control over the abilities of a computer or microprocessor. In this unit, we are going to learn about assembler directives, to be specific. And then we are going to learn about actual instructions which are used to write microprocessor programs in assembly level language. There are different instruction set available with respect to different family of processors. We are specifically going to learn about capabilities of 8086 microprocessor. And then very important thing to do input and output operations. To be exact, how a microprocessor can respond to input and output devices. This is actually using the interrupts. There is a concept called as interrupts. So interrupts will indicate the microprocessor that a input or output device is awaiting and you have to switch your task. You have to stop your current task and you have to cooperate with the specified device. You can enable interrupts, you can disable interrupts. There are so many other capabilities which can be built using interrupts. And then finally, we are going to learn about interrupts, how they can be used in a higher level programming language. We know to write system softwares, for instance, device drivers, a lower level programming language might be much helpful. But however, using these capabilities in a higher level programming language such as C is also possible. How exactly we can utilize these capabilities in C programming language? All these things we are going to learn in this course. And I am very sure you are going to learn lot many concepts and it will be very interesting, and I wish happy learning.